I'm so good. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
How are you?
Good. How are you?
No, we'll take you one if you need it.
No, that's okay.
Okay.
On getting up each morning.
How exciting is it to have this brand new cool building?
Very exciting.
Where were you before?
We were in the bells were in the basement of University Church, in a very, very small room where we barely had enough room.
And this is better?
Yes.
The performance venue is so much better to rehearse and learn your parts and be the professional organization that they are.
And rehearsal space that allows handicapped people to be involved,
absolutely,
which they did not have.
Hold on to it.
Okay.
You're getting videoed in the process.
Okay, are we getting ready?
Yeah, well, that's a great place back to see.
Okay.
Is this a future Glee Clubber?
Yes.
Could be.
Or Purdue, I don't know.
Yeah, she's got a good singing voice.
It's pretty good.
How are you?
Thank you for all your help.
How are you doing?
Good,
yourself? Good. Yeah. Yeah.
Chilling.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
You ever did that?
You know, what job was ever like that?
Today we're here dedicating Ralph and Bettye Bailey Hall. It's been a long time coming, and we're so happy to see this dream come true.
Why is it so cool?
It's the most amazing building on the planet with the most amazing students. And we have so many people here we want to thank and couldn't thank them enough.
How many people attending today and how many can sing?
I think, hopefully all of them. There's more than two. It's probably close to 300 now. We've had a lot of folks show up today that are interested in knowing more about what we do and celebrating this great building here with the Bailey family and all these amazing people that contributed to making this possible for our kids.
You're
saying you were a Purdue? Let's get it.
No, I was. I had more hair then.
Do you want to introduce Claire?
This is
our youngest daughter, Claire. She's a senior at Purdue.
Hi, hello. So it's Claire, it's Ralph. Pleasure to meet you.
Ralph and Ben.
Are you a Purdue Ed?
Yes.
Amanda Bailey.
Ben.
Yeah.
You're on film.
Everybody want to go by.
Delighted here. This is a wonderful thing. I hope you feel as good about it as everybody here at Purdue does.
Let me tell you what's so nice.
Ralph, since I heard him mention golf, since I was his partner, I thought I'd come see you.
Oh, he's just immediately gone.
Oh, you're so kind.
From Fishers, Indiana, studying computer graphic technology with minors in forensic science and theater. I'll be graduating this May and hope to return to Washington, D.C. to continue my work with forensic imaging, either with the Secret Service or with the FBI. I'm currently the manager of the Purdue Varsity Glee Club and have been a proud member of the Glee Club since I was a freshman.
And my name is Grace Bagshaw. I'm a senior from Warsaw, Indiana, double majoring in dietetics and nutrition, fitness, and health. I'm currently pursuing opportunities for my supervised practice experience in dietetics in order to become a registered dietitian after graduation in May 2015. I've been a four-year member of the Purdueettes and now serve as the manager. In 2013, Ryan and I had the experience of a lifetime as we performed throughout Austria, Germany, Switzerland, and France as a part of PMO's largest international performance tour.
As you can imagine, both of us are honored and privileged to be here today and take part in this long-awaited dedication and to introduce the special guests and dignitaries with us today. Please stand and be recognized as we introduce you. We are honored with the presence of former and current members of the Purdue University Board of Trustees. Would you please stand as a group and be recognized?
A few of our vice presidents and deans have joined us today. Would you please stand and be recognized?
And now please welcome the director of Purdue Musical Organizations, Bill Gripple.
Well, the wait is finally over. I am tremendously honored to represent Purdue Musical Organizations as we celebrate this momentous milestone that's been generations in the making. Today's students and staff recognize that this beautiful achievement is made possible by the combined efforts of incredibly generous alumni, donors, and friends, and the work of the students and staff that came before us. We are the first beneficiaries of many to come that will have the privilege of operating our one-of-a-kind program in a state-of-the-art facility that has been custom-built to meet our unique needs. Our new home provides large and small practice rooms, an environmentally controlled and easily accessible equipment storage space right behind me, and opportunities to spotlight PMO's rich history and traditions, which I'm excited for you all to have a chance to take a look at after this ceremony. Bailey Hall is already attracting students and community traffic, raising awareness of our programs and boosting our recruitment efforts. We are grateful that the accessibility, safety, and sunlight are no longer absent from our home, and now it's my privilege to say thank you to some very special people who made this day possible. First and foremost, on behalf of all of the students and staff who came before, those who I'm proud to represent today, and those who will come after, I want to say a heartfelt thank you to Ralph and Bettye Bailey. I know I speak for many in attendance today when I say that your unwavering confidence, your unmatched leadership, and your remarkable patience during this entire process has been the guiding light that has brought us to this moment. Having the opportunity to get to know you and see firsthand your passion for PMO has been one of the greatest joys of my career. None of this would be possible without you. Thank you for making our dreams come true. We are honored to have many members of the Bailey family with us today. I want to thank Cinda and Doug and Lisa and the entire Bailey family for not only sharing this day with us, but for sharing this dream with us. We are forever grateful for what your generosity has made possible for our students and our program. And say amen to that. Please know we consider all of you a very, very special part of our PMO family. To the hundreds of other Bailey Hall donors who helped make this day possible, thank you for joining us on this journey and for your commitment to making this dream a reality. We would not be here without any of you. I especially want to thank those donors who have named spaces inside this facility. We have recognized you inside today's program, and I ask you to please stand at this time so we may thank you for your extraordinary support. There are a few more special thank yous I would like to make. As Ryan and Grace shared, in May of 2013, PMO embarked on the largest international performance tour in our program's history, and it was a marvelous success. This tour had originally been announced for May of 2012, though our focus on finishing the fundraising for Bailey Hall led us to postpone this tour by 1 year. This decision impacted a group of students who missed out on the opportunity to travel internationally as a part of PMO, and we invited these students, who are all now alumni, to join us today. I ask these alumni please stand at this time so we may recognize you with a round of applause. I also want to thank everyone who helped design and build our beautiful new home, especially our Purdue project manager, Jim DeVille, and our friends with Schmidt Associates and Kettle Hut Construction. We were able to move into our new home ahead of schedule thanks to their exceptional efforts. Now, I would now like to ask David Lasseter and Annette Lamb to please stand. As many of you know, David and Annette have worked tirelessly to help connect the passions of many of you here today with the needs of our program. Their commitment and that of Julie and Reed Riccardi, Jolie Haven, Lance Connolly, Steve Schlenk, and all of our friends in development has been instrumental in making Bailey Hall, a building paid for entirely with gift funds, possible. Thank you all. And finally, on behalf of the PMO staff, I want to thank our PMO students who give so generously of their time and talents. You are the best part of our new home, and we consider it our privilege to have the opportunity to work with you each and every day. Organized choral music here at Purdue dates back to 1891, but it was not until 1933 that Purdue Musical Organizations was founded by Dr. Albert P. Stewart. It all started with Al, who was PMO's first full-time director, before Bill Lumen, Bill Allen, Brian Breed, and myself. Bailey Hall opens a brand new chapter in a storied 81-year history of PMO, and is arriving during an exciting time. During the last school year, PMO students performed for more than 125,000 people during 134 shows in 37 cities across 10 states. Each ensemble's average GPA has climbed to a 3.07 or higher, marking the first time all of our ensembles have been above a 3.0 since we renewed our focus on academic success as a part of our strategic plan. Last December, we welcomed our largest audience in 6 years to the annual Purdue Christmas show. And at a time when affordability is more important than ever, PMO is proud to offer more than $300,000 in scholarship support to our students each year. Today, as we celebrate the culmination of this journey, we're also looking forward to a very bright future for a program we all love. We're seeing inspiring examples among our PMO students of the talent, energy, intellectual curiosity that will move our world forward. Our students report that participating in our program helps them demonstrate professionalism, develop meaningful relationships, communicate effectively, and as we all know, learn to manage their time. This learning will certainly serve as a catalyst for their future success and Ralph and Bettye Bailey Hall, which will serve as a home away from home for current and future generations of PMO students, will play a starring role in helping their dreams come true. Thank you all for joining us today, and Ralph and Bettye, you were right all along. Failure was not an option. We did it. At this time, I would like to invite Ashley Nelms to the stage. Ashley is a junior from Lawrenceville, Illinois, studying computer graphics technology. Now, last year, Ashley competed with 58,000 singers from 63 countries in the Voice of McDonald's vocal competition. Last spring, she represented not only Purdue, but all of North America in the global finals, where she won third prize. Ashley will be performing a beautiful arrangement of a song I think you will recognize. Thank you all again.
Stagecraft to not make that mistake. That was spectacular, as you are every time we get a chance to hear you. I'm one of those millions of people who somewhere along in their life were lucky enough to take part in vocal groups, church choirs, high school, and so forth. Nothing ever quite so proficient as the Purdueettes or the Glee Club. But even a glancing acquaintance with music, vocal music, or otherwise, enriches a person's life, brings them in some proximity to the beauty that often inexpressible, but is without which life, and certainly life on a campus like this, is not ever the same. We're big on tradition at Purdue. It's one of the things I love best about it. And one of our traditions is we want to open a new music building every 75 years. So we were due, and here we are, and about time. Those of you who haven't yet had a chance to go inside are going to be so thrilled. Not only a marvelous, I'm sure, perfectly designed facility for the purposes that it'll serve for singers present and future, but it's a museum in a way. It's a history of music at Purdue. And that's such an interesting history. I mean, I started hearing about it well before I got here, and because it strikes some people as a little surprising that a school known for our traditional strengths in the sciences and agriculture and engineering and so forth should have this fabulous tradition. I love to tell people, and they're who wouldn't otherwise know. that we have far more students today involved in one or another of our musical groups, vocal or instrumental, than all the athletes put together. So I know that this is an audience full of people who benefited from that and built that tradition. We thank everybody for all the contributions, financial, but yes, but artistic, and the volunteer time and so forth that went into this joyous day. And of course, most particularly, we thank the Baileys. If we have tradition, and if we have legends that we revere here at Purdue, I don't know of one that means more to us than this family, and this couple in particular. And Ralph and Bettye, you will have to take my word for this, but you are loved, you are thought of here, day in, day out. This happens to be a day when we will celebrate you in particular, but don't ever imagine that your name doesn't come up all the time. It does. You've given lives of leadership at this university. So, not just for this building, but for everything you have meant, everything you meant through the lives you have led, great examples of what Boilermaker can be, we thank you and we love you, and now would like to invite you to come and accept a small token of this university's esteem. Try to be very careful not to pull it off the stand, and you be careful not to drop it on the way home.
Grateful to be here with my parents, Ralph and Bettye, my sisters, Cinda, Lisa, and our many extended family members. In particular, I'm so pleased that our father's sister, Irene Dimmitt, has come here for the dedication as she approaches the tender young age of 96 on December 31st of this year. Along with thanking the leadership and students of Purdue, our family wishes to especially thank PMO Director Bill Griffel, Associate Vice President of Advancement David Lassiter and his colleagues, and the generous contributions of so many other Purdue alumni and friends for helping our parents make this a reality. It was 72 years ago that Ralph Bailey enrolled at Purdue. With World War II interrupting his studies, he came home from the war in 1945. He immediately married the woman who was to become our mother, and who supported him through his graduation in 1949. We grew up hearing only fond memories of Purdue University from both our parents. This university shaped their lives, and opportunities made possible when an importance placed on education. Seeing them work with the President's Council here inspired us to recognize the importance of giving back to one's university, so that similar opportunities are created for the next generation of students. But a well-rounded education is achieved by building around the classroom a community in which a rich diversity of experience is possible, such as athletics, and the arts. And within the Purdue community, it was this music that so inspired our parents. Music fills your soul, and it sets the rhythm of your lives. And without music, my wife Sarah and I could not dance. And so hail music and hail Purdue. And it's with great pleasure I'd like to introduce my father, Ralph Bailey, to share with you their inspiration in his own words.
I think I had $800 in the pocket, a hard-won scholarship from the state of Indiana, Purdue ran two scholarships just for county. So I had a competition. Well, I graduated after the Bailey Hall for participating in World War II. And with a degree in mechanical engineering. And my whole piece of what one would say educational opportunity that gave me the strength and the courage to march ahead. And now somebody might tell me to retire. I'm not in the mood to do so. Well, it's so nice of all you folks to be here. I'm proud of the fact that many of my good friends are here and all this great students and singers. And for all that, I say thank you and God bless you.
Would you do us the honor of giving us a starting pitch for a song near and dear to our hearts?
Singing,
there is no
and even when there are no sounds at all.
after this dedication, please join us for tours of our magnificent new home.
And enjoy the reception. President Daniels and Bill Griffel, please come forward.
Is everybody ready? Yeah.
Here we go.
Five,
four,
three,
two,
one.
Yeah, right.